loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Hello, my dear children. Auntie hopes and prays that you are having a good time at home with your family. If you are not feeling well, or if you are feeling a bit sad or scared, Auntie prays that you won't feel like that anymore, and if you are not feeling well, that you will feel better and you will recover soon. So, today's story is about a young boy. A young boy like y'all. So, this boy's name was Timothy. He lived a long time ago. His story is found in the Bible, in the New Testament. So, why don't we go and have a look at our video for today, and then we'll learn more about Timothy.
Timothy grew up in a home that loved God. His mother, Eunice, and his grandmother, Lois, would always read the Bible to him. They would pray together and give thanks to God. They wanted to give Timothy the best start. One day, Paul arrived in Timothy's village. Paul knew God had a special plan for Timothy. Paul helped Timothy to grow in faith. Paul took Timothy on his missionary journeys. Timothy was a great helper. Later, when Paul was in prison, he wrote two letters to Timothy. He thanked Timothy for serving others. Paul was in prison, but he knew Timothy was doing a great job looking after the church. Paul wrote letters to help Timothy and told him always to trust Scripture. Timothy shared Paul's letters and taught others. Even though he was young, he set an example for others. Timothy preached the gospel, took care of churches, and helped people grow in faith. Timothy honored God.
What an amazing little story! This boy Timothy grew up with his mother and his grandmother, and they taught him how to pray, how to read the Bible. Those days the Bible was not like a book, it was rolled up like paper, and that's how they stored their books. So they used to open up the scroll and then read the Bible. So Timothy grew up learning about God from his grandmother and his mother. And even when Paul comes to Timothy's village, Paul knew that God had a big plan for Timothy. Even when Paul was in prison, when he was in jail, he wrote letters to Timothy, telling Timothy how he should be, what he should do, and telling Timothy and encouraging Timothy in his work for the church, teaching others about God. And what did Timothy do? Of course, he taught others about God. He preached the gospel, the video said, and he set an example. Even though he was young, he set an example to the people in the church, in his village, to his family, to everyone around him who saw him. Timothy was a great example, and he is a great example to us even now. Even though you are young, or you're small, or you think you are not important, you are very important. Each of y'all are important in God's eyes, and God has a great plan for each and every one of you. Even if you are young, don't think that you are not ready to do work for God. God can use you in great ways. So what must you do? You must set an example to everyone around you. Read your Bible, say your prayers. When the Sunday schools are open, you go to Sunday school. When the churches are open, you go to church. Be friendly and loving and kind with everyone around you. And tell others about Jesus and how much Jesus loves them. These are the things that Timothy did when he was also growing up, just like you and me. So, in this way, let's take the story of Timothy into our hearts and try to be like Timothy who set an example with his life even though he was young. You remember how Auntie said that the story of Timothy is found in the New Testament? There are two books in the New Testament named 1 Timothy and 2 Timothy, and both of those books are stories about Timothy and all the work that he did. For our Bible verse for today, Auntie will be reading from 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 12 says, "Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity." So this is what our Bible verse for today says. It says, don't let anyone look down at you because you are young. Don't let anyone say, he is young, no, that's why he's doing things like this. Or, she is young, no, that is why nobody is listening to what she is saying. No, the way you live should set an example so that even elders around you will take your advice, listen to you, and learn from you. You can learn from even children. Auntie knows this very much. You can set an example to the people in your family even, and your neighborhood, and people you meet. Be an example. The Bible verse says, in faith, in conduct, how you behave, how you treat others, being a Christian, and how you talk. It says about your speech, if you're saying a lot of naughty words, and always scolding your brothers and sisters, and telling things about your parents and all, then that is not the way Jesus wants you to be. You have to set an example to be a good example so that others will see and know that yes, even though this girl or this boy is small, God is working in their lives and they are setting a great example for all of us. So that is what our Bible verse is for today. Now let's go and see what our handwork is for this week. Hello children, so for today's handwork, we will be needing a piece of cardboard, a piece of ribbon, our scissors, some gum, some marker pens. We will also be needing a photo of yours and any scraps of cloth that you have lying around in your house and some cellotape. Now on this board, we are going to make a picture frame to put your picture in the middle. We're going to paste your picture in the middle. So if your board is too big, you can cut it to the shape you want. Auntie might cut this board a bit more smaller and make it into a smaller square. After we do that, we will take whatever cloth we have lying around in our houses that are not used, and we will decorate our frame. So first let's cut the frame. So Auntie had this piece of board at home and Auntie used this. I cut the piece a bit more smaller. Now remember that photo I told you to find? Roughly Auntie's photo is this size. This is a picture of Auntie when Auntie was smaller. So we are going to paste our photo by keeping a little space at the bottom like this. So what we will do now is paste our photograph on the piece of cardboard. After we paste our picture on our board, we will also be needing a small piece of A4 paper. Cut it roughly to half the size of your photograph size. And then we will write something on it. Let's see what we're going to write on it. Auntie cut this small piece of paper. Now on this, you remember our Bible verse for today from 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 12. How it said that we should set an example. We are going to write now saying, I will set an example. And we will write down the parts of the Bible verse using the word I. So that you are telling that you will set an example like the Bible has told us to. So let's write that now. Auntie wrote it like this. I will set an example in my speech, my conduct, in love, in my faith, in my purity. And I pasted it there. If there is not enough space at the bottom, you can move it a bit higher and cover a part of your photograph if need. Now let's decorate it by covering our frame with the cloth that we have. You can cut the cloth in different shapes and sizes and paste it along the border. And Auntie covered the frame with one design piece of cloth. See, like this. And there is space for our little words here. And Auntie also stuck a piece of ribbon at the back with silver tape. So now you can hang this in your room. And every time you see this, you will be reminded that you should be an example to everyone around you. So I hope you enjoy making your very own picture frame and hanging it in your room. Today we're going to learn a song. The song is a song Auntie learned when Auntie was in Sunday school. It's called I Love You Jesus Deep Down in My Heart. It's an action song. So do the actions along and let's learn this new chorus. I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart. I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart. Talk about deep, deep, down, down, deep down in my heart. Talk about deep, deep, down, down, deep down in my heart. I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart. I love you, Jesus, deep down in my heart. Let's bring this week's Sunday school lesson to a close with a prayer. Let us pray and you can say the prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for this beautiful day. Jesus, help me to be an example to everyone around me. Even though I am young, help me to set a good example to everyone. Jesus, I pray for my country and the world. I pray for everyone who is sick. Jesus, please take care of them and heal everyone who is not feeling well, who is sick because of COVID. Jesus, I commit them all into your hands. I pray that you will keep us all safe and healthy. I love you, Jesus. I pray all this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Don't forget to wear your mask at all times. And always wash your hands and keep them clean.
So till Auntie sees you next week with another amazing Bible story, please take care of yourselves, be obedient to your parents and guardians, and remember that Jesus loves you very, very much. See you soon. Bye.